Dear students, let's make an attempt to know about mulberry production under different agroclimatic conditions. Introduction. Mulberry is a hardy perennial crop capable of thriving under diverse agroclimatic conditions. It responds very well to application of irrigation, manure and fertilizers. It takes 1 year for the establishment and second year onwards full yield is realized and sustained leaf yield is possible up to next 15 years provided for the package of practices for its proper establishment and subsequent maintenance is followed. Mulberry has a potential to yield up to 35 to 60 metric tons of leaf per hectare per year depending upon the variety, climatic conditions and agronomic inputs. However, the variety, method of planting, cultivation and other agronomic aspects varies with the region and climatic conditions. System of planting. There are two systems of planting under irrigated conditions. Number one, the row system and number two, pitch system. In the row system, the rows are 60 cm apart and the cuttings or saplings are planted at a distance of 22 cm, that is 76,923 plants per hectare. In the pitch system, the rows are 60 cm apart and the cuttings or saplings are planted at a distance of 60 cm, that is 27,778 plants per hectare. The other spacing followed are 90 into 90 centimeter, that is 12,346 plants per hectare, 90 plus 150 into 60 centimeter, that is 13,888 plants per hectare, and 90 plus 120 into 60 centimeter, that is 15,873 plants per hectare. Collar system. This is very much popular in collar region wherein ridges and furrows are made at a distance of 0.30 to 0.45 meter. On either side of the ridges, mulberry is planted at a distance of 0.10 to 0.15 meter between the plants along the row in a dense planting. Whole shoot harvest are done for silkworm rearing. In West Bengal, which comes under high rainfall category, a closed system of planting called strip system is followed. In this method, a spacing of 0.6 meter in between strips is made. In each strip, 2 to 3 rows are planted at a distance of 0.5 meter. Distance between the plants in each row is 0.15 meter. In Kashmir, mulberry is grown as tree in a block plantation with a inter-row and inter-plant distance of 2.7 into 2.7 meter. The crown height is maintained at 100 centimeter, which results in triradiate branches. Presently, drop system of plantation with a spacing of 72 into 36 centimeter and a crown height of 50 to 60 centimeter, as well as bush system of plantation with a spacing of 36 into 16 centimeter and a crown height of 15 to 30 centimeter is practiced. In rain-fed and irrigated areas of Jammu and Kashmir division, a spacing of 36 into 36 centimeter and 24 into 24 centimeter is followed for bush system of plantation. A spacing of 72 into 36 centimeter and 72 into 48 centimeter is also followed for dwarf system of plantation. Cultivated varieties. Presently, in Karnataka state, the varieties most suited for irrigated conditions are V1 both for chalky and lattice rearing, G4 for lattice rearing and S36 and G2 for chalky rearing. Whereas, for rain-fed condition with for alkaline soils, Mysore local, S13 and S34 are suited. In Tamil Nadu, the commonly cultivated mulberry varieties are MR2 and Kanwa2, Similarly, in West Bengal, Barampur S1, S799 and S1635 are popular, and hilly regions BC259, TR10 and Kosen are common. In Jammu and Kashmir, the most popular mulberry varieties are China White, Goishrami and Kosen are also varieties belonging to Morus alba. Soil type. Mulberry can be cultivated in a wide range of soil like loamy, red loamy, sandy loam, clay loam, alluvial and black soil. Since it is a deep rooted perennial plant, the soil should be porous and deep for better aeration and movement of water to this root zone, as well as with good drainage and water holding capacity. Besides, the soil should also be fertile. Soil should be slightly acidic with the pH ranging from 6.2 to 6.8. However, mulberry can be tolerated to pH range 5.5 to 9. Alkaline soils should be abundant with application of gypsum or by raising green manure crops. Acidic soils should be abundant with lime. Planting materials. High yielding variety of mulberry recommended for each agroclimatic region should be chosen for planting. Further cuttings from 6 to 8 months old shoots or 3 to 4 months old saplings can be used as planting material to establish the mulberry plantation. When cuttings are used as planting material, they should be 15 to 18 centimeter in length, 1 to 1.5 centimeter in diameter, with 3 to 4 healthy buds. Bush plantation. Preparation of land. Before the onset of monsoon, land is floored to a depth of 40 centimeter using the disc floor, followed by moldboard floor, and finally with the cultivar to bring the soil to a fine tilth and weed free condition. Further, the land is leveled. FOM is applied at the rate of 20 metric tons per hectare and thoroughly incorporated into the soil. Land can be divided into plots of convenient size suited for mechanization. Plantation. Mulberry planting work is ideally taken up during rainy season for better establishment. For 60 into 60 centimeter planting system, ridges and furrows are made alternatively at a distance of 16 centimeters. If cuttings are used as planting material, they are planted along the margin of the ridges at the rate of 2 cuttings per spot. Cuttings should be inserted into the soil, exposing one bud. If plantation is by saplings, then one sapling is planted in each spot along the ridges. Planting of saplings is more appropriate for better establishment of plants. This system of planting is ideal when spacing of 90 into 90 centimeter is adopted. For this purpose, pits of 35 into 35 into 35 centimeter are dug and then filled with a mixture of farmyard manure and soil. In hilly areas as also rain-fed areas, 3 cuttings of 20 to 22 centimeter length with 4 to 5 healthy buds and about 1.5 centimeter in diameter are planted per pit, with a spacing of 15 centimeter between cuttings in a triangular form. Within 3 to 4 days of planting, saplings are to be pruned at a height of 10 to 15 centimeter above the ground level. Care during the establishment period. During the establishment period, irrigation should be provided at regular intervals of 7 to 10 days depending on the soil condition. Weeding is carried out manually after 2 months of planting. When the plantation is 3 months old, first dose of chemical fertilizer is applied at the rate of 50:50:50 kg NPK per hectare. First leaf harvest is done 6 months after plantation. The second weeding is completed after the leaf harvest, and the second dose of fertilizer, that is 50 kg nitrogen, is applied within 3 weeks of leaf harvest. Further, 2 more leaf harvest can be taken at an intervals of 3 months in the first year. After the third leaf harvest, when the plants are around 1 year old, bottom pruning is done at a height of 20 cm above the ground level. Maintenance of irrigated mulberry garden. Irrigation. In sandy loam soil, irrigation has to be carried out at 7 to 8 days intervals. Mulberry requires 1.5 to 2 acre inch of irrigation water per irrigation, that is 1 acre inch is equal to 22,687 gallons. 1 gallon is equal to 4.55 liters. Drip system of irrigation can also be followed to save 30% of water is compared to furrow irrigation. Manures and fertilizers. Farmyard manure or sericompost is applied at the rate of 20 metric tons per hectare per year for irrigated mulberry garden and 10 metric tons per hectare per year for rain-fed mulberry garden. Chemical fertilizers. Chemical fertilizers are applied in 5 spread doses corresponding to the 5 leaf or shoot harvests. The fertilizers are applied within 3 weeks of the last leaf or shoot harvest in furrows at 5 to 8 cm deep and covered with soil to minimize the loss due to the volatilization, and immediately irrigated. Recommended fertilizer for shoot harvest system is 300:120:120 kg NPK per hectare per year. For rain-fed mulberry garden, the recommended dose of fertilizer is 100:50:50 kg NPK per hectare per year. In case of V1 variety, which is capable of faster shoot growth and higher biomass production, fertilizer dose of 350:140:140 kg NPK per hectare per year is applied in 5 equal splits of 70:28:28. In hilly areas such as Malnad and Western Ghats, fertilizer dosage recommended is 200:75:75 kg NPK per hectare per year. The leaf quality and production can be increased by foliar application of vipul at the rate of 250 ml per hectare per crop in 2 equal splits of 125 ml each in 600 liters of water. The first spraying is done 10 to 15 days after the pruning or shoot harvest, and the second spraying is done 15 days after the first spray. Intercultural operations. Intercultural operations are carried out after each leaf harvest and pruning. Its main purpose is to loosen the soil for better aeration, thus facilitating better root growth, removal of weeds, clearing and deepening of irrigation channels. Thus, 500 man days are required for intercultural operations in 1 hectare mulberry garden for 1 year. Harvesting of leaf and shoot. Leaf picking. Leaves are harvested 45 days after pruning and continued over the next 25 days. The advantages of this method are that appropriate leaves can be selected to suit the growth stage of the larvae. However, it requires considerable labor, and the leaves after harvest should be covered with wet gunny cloth. Otherwise, they wither off. Shoot harvest. In this method, the branches are cut at first level, that is 20 cm above the ground level, and the entire shoot is fed to silkworm after fourth molt. Shoots are harvested at intervals of 60 to 70 days, and thus 5 to 6 harvests can be made in a year. The advantages of shoot harvest. Leaves remain attached to the stem and stay fresh over a long period, facilitating prolonged feeding by silkworms. Labor saving up to 70% as compared to leaf picking method. Also, as shoot harvest is combined with pruning of the mulberry plants, 25 man days per hectare required for the pruning can be saved every year. Improvement in the cocoon character and ERR. Better hygienic conditions can be maintained. Pruning of mulberry garden. Mulberry, a perennial tree in the wild, is maintained as a bush for sericulture purposes by artificial pruning. This practice not only improves the leaf yield and quality, but also facilitates repeated harvesting of the leaf. Depending upon the planting system, under varied agroclimatic conditions, different system of pruning are followed. Number 1, bottom pruning. Number 2, middle pruning. Number 3, drop pruning. And number 4, collar system. Schedules of operations in a year for mulberry garden. With the commencement of the southwest monsoon early June, the annual bottom pruning is carried out. Weeding and intercultural operations is carried out within 1 week of pruning. Farm-made manure or sericompost is applied within a fortnight of the pruning and thoroughly incorporated into the soil. After 3rd week of pruning, fertilizer application 60:60:60 kg NPK per hectare in 1st and 3rd crops is done. After application of fertilizer in furrows, it is covered with soil and immediately irrigated. Nitrogenous fertilizer is applied in the 2nd, 4th and 5th crops. Mulberry as tree plantation. Mulberry as tree can be raised in wasteland, denuded areas and as block plantation in waste sheds development. It is a fast growing tree and hence produces very large quantity of renewable biomass in the form of branches, shoots, leaves and fruits. Thus, by growing mulberry, it is possible to use the leaves as food for silkworm and as fodder for cattle and goats. The dried branches can be used as fuel. 1 kg of mulberry wood produces 4600 calories. Accordingly, mulberry can be utilized by raising it as an energy plantation in cultivable wastelands, watersheds, channels, burns, roadsides, etc. It can be exclusively used for social forestry as the tree plays an important role in soil conservation and preservation of soil erosion. Establishment of tree mulberry. Raising of saplings. Saplings should be raised 5 to 6 months prior to their direct plantation in the month of February with the onset of warm weather in South India. Saplings meant for tree mulberry plantation are raised in nursery beds for convenient size, that is 8.5 × 1.2 meter. Cuttings are planted with a spacing of 15 cm with the row and 30 cm between the rows. The wider spacing helps in the development of saplings with a well developed root system. Spacing. The topography of the soil, extent of land available for tree, planting and the purpose for which the trees are arranged determine the spacing to be adopted. In case of plants with gently slope, 1.5 × 1.5 meter spacing can be adopted. In case of land with a slipper slope, the spacing adopted is 1.5 meter between the plants and 3 meters between the rows. plants must be planted in rows across the slope to minimize the soil erosion. In large extent of cleared forest land with the undulating surface, 2.4 into 2.4 meter or 3 into 3 meter spacing is more suitable. Land preparation. Land preparation for tree cultivation is different from bush cultivation. Depending on the spacing to be adopted, spots for pit making are measured and make with picks. In case of loose structure and deep soils, pits of 45 into 45 into 45 centimeter can be dug. In case of hard and shallow soils, pits of 60 into 60 into 60 centimeters can be dug. Pits preparation should be started soon after the receipt of pre-monsoon showers. 1 week prior to planting, pits should be filled with mixture of well decomposed farmyard manure or compost and soil. If the soil is clayey, about 2 iron pans of sand or red earth is applied into each pit. In hilly or forest soils which are acidic, lime application is at the rate of 500 grams per pit is necessary along with the farmyard manure. Mulberry varieties suitable for growing as tree in South India are Kanwa 2 and V1 in irrigated areas and S36 in rain-fed conditions. In West Bengal, S1 variety and in North India, Sujanpur 5 variety can be used for raising tree plantation. All these varieties can be easily propagated by vegetative means and characterized by good growth and leaf yield. Sapling plantation. It is most suitable for raising trees and is undertaken only after regular onset and monsoon so that sufficient moisture is available in the soil. Saplings are 5 to 6 months age with a height of 1.5 into 1.8 meter can be used for planting. One sapling must be planted in each pit and it should be planted deep and straight in the center of the pit. As the saplings are 150 to 180 centimeter tall, they should be protected from wind by providing a support of stick and tied to it properly. Subsequently to planting, if the rains fall, pot watering is done for proper establishment of the plants. After care of plantation. As the saplings are planted in monsoon season, they establish quickly and form sufficient canopy in short period. Deep plantation of saplings facilitates faster growth with a deep rooted system. Sprouting of the buds start 10 to 15 days after planting and they must be allowed to sprout up to 1 month. After 1 month, all the lower buds except the top 5 to 6 buds should be removed carefully with a sharp knife without damaging the bark. Weeds growing around the plants are removed at regular monthly intervals. After 3 months of planting, about 25 grams of Sufala should be applied in a trench made around each plant and the same covered with soil and watered. Before the cessation of the monsoon, the second dose of fertilizer as used urea at the rate of 25 gram per plant is given. Maintenance of tree plantation. On second year onwards, plants will attain a height of 2.4 to 3 meter after 1 year of planting. With the onset of monsoon, plants are given the first pruning during May-June at a height of 90 centimeter from ground level in spacing of 1.5 into 1.5 meter and at a height of 120 centimeter in spacing of 2.4 into 2.4 meter and 3 into 3 meter leaving 3 to 4 buds on each primary branch. Soon after pruning, 5 kg that is 1 iron pan of well decomposed farmyard manure or compost must be applied around the plant followed by thorough digging and weeding. After 1 month of the pruning, when the buds begin to sprout, chemical fertilizers must be applied. The second pruning is done 15 cm above the first cut before the cessation of rain, that is October-November. The third pruning is done another 15 cm above the second cut with the onset of monsoon shower to maintain a final crown height of 120 cm in case of 1.5 into 1.5 meter spacing and 150 cm in case of 2.4 into 2.4 meter and 3 into 3 meter spacing. Mulberry is a perennial and hardy crop capable of thriving under diverse agroclimatic conditions. It responds very well to application of irrigation, manures and fertilizers. It takes 1 year for the establishment and sustained leaf yield is possible up to next 15 years with proper maintenance. Mulberry has a potential to yield up to 35 to 60 metric tons of leaf per hectare per year depending upon the variety, climatic conditions and agronomic inputs. However, the variety, method of planting, cultivation and other agronomic aspects vary with the regions and climatic conditions. Thank you.